The topic that we've been given is the calm before the storm. According to me, is really the storm before the calm. I mean, could we, as an industry, be in a much bigger whirlpool as we are finding ourselves? It's really now a question of how do you get to a stable, calm situation, calm position, especially for residential. I must say we're only talking about residential because commercial is a very different story. My first three questions that I need answers from. Number one, what is the calm? What is healthy for residential? When do you think you will get to that stage when these three big events are behind you? The second question is, how do you get the buyer back? Because really, honestly, the way I look at it, the buyer should start coming back, especially after 31st July when all projects have their RERA registration. But will he come back and why should he come back? And the final question is that post-RERA, what will differentiate branded players from non-branded players when all information is available readily, and why should I, as a buyer, pay any premium for branded projects? First question, so what is the calm? Mr. Jijna, I'm going to ask you, so you know, we all know what's happening to residential real estate. In a storm, how do we reach to the calm? When do we reach to the calm? And how will you define the new calm?
Actually, the storm started a few years ago, more than 2 years ago. We have been saying this from our platform that we are seeing consolidation happening. This is the downturn for the first time where sales velocity has been affected. And because of that, that consolidation has started. What do we mean by consolidation? Is that the buyers have started selecting the good developers from the bad developers. The people who are having corporate governance, who are delivering the product where the money is safe. RERA was coming, everybody knew about it. It is only going to accelerate the death of unorganized people. Unfortunately, the storm is going on because of GST. You know, as Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani said, the three tsunamis have come in this downturn. So that is actually prolonging this whole thing. But the important point I would like to make, because we definitely have data which is primary, much better than most of the people or the lenders in the country today, is that even post demonetization, we saw from our data, we have more than 300 projects which we have funded all India. We saw that the developers who have embraced corporate governance, who are doing well in the eyes of the public, even after demonetization, could sell their products. And it goes on. So that is why this definition of industry, of the calm, I think this whole definition is changing. It will be those developers, or as we call it, the 20-80 rule, probably the 20% developers will survive. And I can say this today with confidence, because in fact, as I say it jokingly, we are no more in the lending business today, Piramal Finance. We are actually in the marriage counselor business. On a daily basis, if I'm not exaggerating, we have developers who have turned themselves into landlords, literally, and ask us to get them married to the developers who are the developers for the future. Mm.
So here's my question. Everybody is facing the brunt of this storm, isn't it? Branded, not branded?
It is, but Khushru said one thing which is right. For example, some of our properties, we are back to 90% of the sales we were doing.
You are? Okay, that's good news.
But the point is, the life is going to change after RERA. Apart from these three tsunamis, we had the budget taking away the interest on the second house and the third house. So a lot of this froth is going to go away. Also, the hype will be known on the website. If you want to sell now, you have to have the right product and have the right customer. It's like a large consumer durable. You will have to do that research. You'll have to figure out what is my offering and which of the customer I choose. And it'll become very, very specific. As you see next 2-3 years, you will see a lot of these elements coming into play, Manisha. But I think it'll be quite some time before we see the calm. It's not going to happen in a hurry.
Are you willing to bet a time?
Not before a year.
Okay, Bamini Rani, what would you consider as a healthy state? What kind of numbers? Let's just then, you know, start breaking it down. Is it sales numbers which will tell you that, okay, fine, we're in a good position? What is it? What parameter would you use?
Very simply, Manisha, if you look at the entire intent of the government, it is to be able to make homes for all. And they've amplified this in every aspect of what they've done, whether it was the finance minister, you know, announcing the budget in 17 minutes talking about housing, whether it was bringing about RERA, even though they were, you know, halfway guesses and whether the states would live up to it. Once this intent has been made clear, I think what's important for all of us developers to understand is it's not only just the numbers, it is also to be able to align ourselves to be able to survive for the long term. And when I say survival, it means that we've got to be compliant, like Khushru said, we've got to be someone with a long-term goal or vision in mind. And I say this is still the starting of the storm. The storm is only going to get a little more turbulent. But through this storm, it is the better ships that will sail through with a lot more ease, and those of us that know to navigate these waters. I know I'm being generalist, but I think Khushru said 20% will survive. According to one of the reports that had come out earlier from JLL, the numbers look very, very scary. So all of us, it's a nice race. I think it's a survival of the fittest that will continue, and towards that, we're gearing up. We're not trying to push ourselves in terms of speed. We're trying to build ourselves in terms of strength at this moment in time.
All right. Dharmesh, ready-to-move-in apartments should be selling. Why are they not selling? Because, you know, there is no trust deficit there. The buyer can see the product. So what is he still afraid of?
I don't see all gloom, frankly speaking. Over the last 3 or 4 years, I think this is the largest pent-up over the last 20 years that we've seen in real estate. For the first time, on 1st August, the customer is going to be confident. He'll know that, yes, I have protection available, and there is reason for me to be confident. Over the next 2 years, I still see launches to be slow because all developers are going to reorganize themselves. As Khushru rightly said, there is going to be consolidation. There is going to be reorganization of your own organizations that you will do. So volumes over the next 2 years will come down.
So okay.
On one side, the customer is going to feel confident. On the second side, volumes are going to come down. So obviously, there is going to be still turbulence over the next 6 months, 1 year. But after that, I see a very good, long, stable phase.
So you're saying 1 year? At most 1 year when for the markets to settle down. Naveen Makhija, you believe that? I mean, 1 year post RERA and you will see a new market altogether on many fronts, including buyer confidence returning, markets getting cleaned up, organized, etc.
So we actually see ready possession moving. We don't see any problem there. I think under construction, we are seeing people buying at the very initial stage. Not during the sustenance phase, but then again at the end. So there's a shift. Earlier you would have people buying throughout the life cycle of
that's
the project.
That's interesting.
But today you'll see at the launch stage, the people who believe in that location, they want to buy it. And right at the end, once they see the product. So there's a lull period of during construction. And rightly so, because prices have in the last 3-4 years have not shot up. So he's like, let me wait and let me see the product and buy. And anyway, the price is not moving up.
I think it's a storm before the typhoon, before the hurricane, before the tidal wave, before the calm.
Okay, great. Love it. So how long will these cycles be?
It'll be two years transition chaos in which there's going to be opportunity and threat. Mm-hmm. For the 80%, for the unorganized, it's going to be straight from ICU to the morgue.
Okay.
And for the others, it's going to be chaos, but we're going to come back into good health in maybe 12 months and maybe 24 months. Sustainable growth. I'm not saying prices are going to go rocking up. They can't. We are, however, dictated by high replacement costs, especially MMR, the biggest of which is our premiums, which keep going up. So we will see sustainable inflation, prices will go up a little bit of time, and good health in terms of velocity and decent margins starting 2019.
All right, Mr. Garadia, now, your comment on everybody's saying that, all right, this is what I heard in 2015 also, that the worst is behind us and things will start improving.
Yeah.
RERA was an event everybody was aware would happen. GST was an event we weren't sure when it'll happen. Demonetization was, of course, took everybody by surprise and hit real estate the hardest. Are you confident now that as these three things settle down, the buyer will come back?
So the thing is, as everybody said, and we also agree that after this three tsunami, things are almost quite settled. The clarity, available information to customers and all is available. The pricing point of view also, definitely what we have, what we see, since 3 years the prices are steady, it's not moving. So it is almost at the price which is definitely a price which is almost lowest or the bottom. the cost of other construction cost, even the premium cost, everything is going up. So customer point of view, it's a right time to buy. And then proper awareness is also there with the customer that if they want to buy a property, they were waiting for this GST, RERA and the things. So now everything is clear. So we do expect gradually the market will pick up.
Here's my question, Baman. There was a year ago, HDFC came out with a report and said, look at the way salaries have increased. Look at the house prices, the way they've increased. Salaries have outstripped home prices increase in India. Then you, since that report, your interest rates have come down from double digit to single digit. You have government announcing mid-income scheme. So on paper, if I do the math, it all looks like the buyer should be back after 1st August. He's a RERA registered project, likes the location, likes the amenities, likes the builder, the salesperson across the table and says, yeah, I should go ahead and buy it. But I worry it will not happen. Do you?
No. Actually, we as Indians always try to catch everything at the lowest point, right? We want to buy everything cheapest and then we want to be the most intelligent by, you know, saying that we got it when it was at its cheapest. I think there's a lot of confusing articles and that's driving the consumer actually into a bigger circle than he would like to be in. My view is, Manisha, you will have a tremendous buy side push. You know, comfort or rather the security that now people are more accountable, developers are more accountable.
Okay.
Also the entire push by the government to say that we are more accountable as a government, so there's the rights to services, etc., through which, you know, Honorable Chief Minister has also been bringing to the attention of the people that we've got an avenue to go and complain. The activism on the part of, you know, an activist brings out the best or the worst in the industry. So all of these factors, I think, are aligning us hugely. I think there's going to be a tremendous demand. And like some of the panelists have mentioned, ready possession flats will be scarce, prices will go up, supply and demand situation will govern that. Good quality, good locations and developers, you know, who've got the RERA badge with them, and you can see the work going on without extended timelines, will again see a great push. So if I am to predict this October, November, sales will be excellent. The turmoil is in the industry, right? It's going to be very, very clear for the buyer after this. We will continue to be hit by all the turmoils that, you know, we've got to kind of regularize ourselves and, you know, be compliant and, you know, prove our compliance, etc. The buyer is going to be absolutely clear after August. And this September, October, November, I think there's going to be a tremendous push. And every one of us who are in the, you know, 70-80% completion stage will see a lot of our good stock at least flying off the shelves.
The fundamentals all align. You guys said yourself, the time factor, time discount, highest TA, lowest EMI, but customers are not dictated by fundamentals or regulatory as much as they're dictated by sentiment. If everybody at my dinner table and every article is saying down, 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 tomorrow an article is saying up, and something GST is down, and somebody is saying RERA is going up, he's so confused, as Baman said. And he's not going to go through the fundamental analysis of replacement cost and premiums, what is perceived supply, what is post-RERA supply, what is low launch. He just listens to his immediate advisor, banker, or friend, or broker who says, khareed ya nahi khareed. So, and as Baman said, they all want to catch the bottom. But the moment the uptick happens, the first early adopter, then it'll be a tidal wave going upwards. We just await that first uptick.
Real estate in India, on an Excel sheet, never owning a real estate wasn't a very financially wise decision. Renting is better if you just did an Excel sheet, right? It was more, if there is big capital appreciation, that there was a charm, right, Dharmesh? Now that everybody knows is probably gone, or at least that's what they've been hearing. Is that correct or wrong?
Again, I would look at challenging that theory over a 10-year period. So different investments have different cycles, right? So clearly, anybody comparing a real estate investment with a stock investment, you're comparing an apple to a banana. So in terms of time cycle, real estate will always be a long-term investment. Hmm. And when you look at the time cycle, I don't think any investment pans out better than real estate. There's no question. Look at it on a 10-year cycle, and real estate will do better than any other investment globally. It's not just India. Anywhere in the world, it'll always give you the best and highest returns. But what all of us are feeling, and not just for saying, I think clearly the worst is over and the curve is moving. At what speed? It can be 3 months and it can be 1 year. But the curve is moving in the right direction is all that I can say for sure.
Okay, the worst is behind, truly? Mr. Jitna, do you really believe finally the worst is over?
Let me also tell you my take why buyers should come in now.
Yes.
You spoke about investors. Let's not forget, this is people. These builders are building houses not for investors, for people who want to stay. And this is nothing but a better time to buy a house for you to stay. And I'll also tell you why. With RERA coming in fact, that is our prediction. And I ask the developers are sitting here. With consolidation already we spoke about, with RERA coming in fact, the developers, Bauman spoke about that the developers who will be following the guidelines will do well. But even, for example, Bauman, if he was doing 4 projects, will actually do 2 projects. Supply is going to come down over a period of 5 to 6 years. And with the guarantees being given, warranties being given for 5 years, who is going to bear the cost? It's ultimately going to be the customer. The prices are going to rise after a few years. This is the time to buy. And this is the problem what Bauman said, I agree, that we want to catch the bottom. It cannot happen. Because when the turn will happen, you'll actually not be able to catch it. So that is why I'm a believer that if you want to buy a house, you should buy it now.
Okay. You know, whether you like it or not, in India, real estate is, or a home that a person, a middle class Indian buys, is his biggest investment, right? So whether he's living in it, he does want to see the prices go up.
True.
And that is, I think, the biggest fear that they have. Ki main aaj khareed raha hu, main apne parivar walon ko yehi nahi bol pa raha hu ki 10% badh gaya. You know, so in 1 year, at least 10%, he has to at least be able to boast in his drawing room, in his next family gathering, that maine itni achhi property khareedi, dekho 10% badh gayi. Wo kab hoga?
You have hit the nail on the head. We are all talking fundamentals. We are not talking the sentimentals. Ultimately, it comes down to that pride of purchase, finding the bottom. But there's a price. First of all, we should stop calling residential as an investment product. It's a home. Anybody who's buying it as an investment is not going to beat. He can probably make more money putting in a mutual fund or FD. If you think you're going to beat the FD rate, or even a corporate FD rate, or even beat a private equity 12, 13, 14% rate, you can't.
Where are you getting private equity 13, 14?
And the structure, whatever. You put in a mutual fund, you get 12 1 year, 14 1 year. You put an FD, you'll get 8, 7. You think you can beat a debt or a stock instrument, you may or may not. You shouldn't buy it with that in mind. Right. And the biggest existential threat we have is rental yields are 2% and mortgages come to 8. There's a 6% delta. That's why jaldi kya help your rent? No. Unless I see the appreciation will beat my mortgage rate.
Right.
Now, that is about 7 to 8 to 10% a year. At least that's sentimental hai. But there's the price purchase paradox. The paradox hai, jab 100 hai, I offer you 90, you won't even buy it at 80. The moment I make it 110, you'll offer me 120. It's the paradox.
Absolutely.
The moment all of us here take 100 to 105 and stick to it, as long as the other guys, each time we did that, somebody announced a scheme. Somebody announced a discount. Somebody announced 5, 15, 10, 0, 11, 100, some combination thereof. Or gave a price, or gave a free Volkswagen. So how can I make it 105, 110 when somebody's dragging his feet and pulling us to 80, 70? But post-RERA, maybe, hopefully, all that structured schemes, unorganized, date delivery, that fraff will go out. All that froth will go out. The noise will go away. It'll take us 6 to 9 months, maybe, for the total noise to die down. There'll be some guys who will do not great registrations. They are so desperate, they have to pay the lenders, they'll register with false information. They will go, there'll be appeals, they'll be indicted. That whole cleanup period could be 9 to 12 months, maybe more.
Okay.
The turning point will be when the guys on this panel can hold at 100, 105, 110, 115, without the other guys constantly going 90, 80 below us.
Okay.
Because the guy, the home purchase, the middle class guy, cannot differentiate between a snazzy ad by Naveen, or by Dharmesh, or by me, or by XYZ.
Last week in Singapore, even in a market like Singapore, which is much more organized, a customer went and said, wow, how much time will you take for delivery? I said, 3 years. When the contract is given, it's 6 years. And he said, you're saying 3? No, no, in the contract we'll write 6. Now that is the truth which will come out in RERA. We can deliver in 3, what the hell are we going to write there? 6 or 5? The 6 is no protection to the customer. Right? But in our country, to write 3 is no protection to the developer.
True.
So that is, although you may have right to service and you can ask, the BMC has made everything computerized, but the time has not changed. To hit his button, his hand is still the issue. So.
Absolutely. Final question. How will branded players now differentiate themselves? They were always charging a premium. But now with RERA, and because we've got some of the biggest branded players here on the dais today, With RERA, even a good developer, small developer, unknown developer could come and actually, with the transparency, inspire the same confidence. Baman, I know you were itching to speak on that.
I think branded is not about just saying that everybody will be able to sell the same product at the same rate. There is that little bit difference between good and excellent, and that is what will come out. People will buy with or with the desire to go ahead and associate with a particular brand. People wear particular type of shoes or branded shoes or particular types of watches. All of them do it at the same time. All our cars do the same job. But we will buy more for the design. We'll buy more for the quality of build, etc. that is there.
Okay. This is a shift. This is a clear shift, because earlier we would say, go with a reputed branded developer because you can be sure that you will get your flat, right? You will get a certain minimum quality. So now the market is going to be way more differentiated, isn't it?
If you allow me a minute, I'll give a very nice example. Just I read day before yesterday. You will have to know your customer. What is the need you're fulfilling? And that is very little research in this industry. There's a hell of a lot in the automobile industry, in FMCG industry. It will come into this industry. Mm-hmm. It will come. Today, there's a craze for small one bedroom. But there could be one bedroom. The customer could be very different from a newly a dings to a single fellow to a family of five. What are you catering to? And then the design has to be very different for that.
Okay.
So a lot of these will come. More innovation on the construction methodology, more on finishes. And one of the things Bombay developers, all of us, our margins are going to go down next 3 years.
Pleasure having all of you as an audience. Thank you very much for your participation.